Hey, what's going on, friends and family? Welcome back to another episode of BKO Reviews. And today, man, I was caught off guard with this pair right here. Honestly, it has no release date. I didn't know it was actually out until I actually went into my local Foot Locker and actually seen it on the shelf. But before we get started with any of that, I definitely want to encourage everyone to hit that thumbs up button. It goes a long way. And also, if you're new to the channel and you haven't subscribed yet, definitely show your love and support by subscribing to the channel. And you can also follow me on these social media platforms. With all that being said, with no further ado, let's get into the review. Well, as you can see, this is something that I picked up from my local Foot Locker. So let's check it out. Voila. As you can see, we have the standard Jordan box with the gold 23 on the actual lid. So let's see what we have today. Today, we're doing a review on a pair of Air Jordan 1 mids with an actual color scheme of black Varsity Maize white and a style code of 554-724-035. And you know, no review will be complete without photo receipt, please.
Say you got it. You say you know me, how you get it, how you got it. You say you bout it. You say you know me, how I get it out the project. I shoot at the Holy Ghost. Hold on the gravitos. I'm sipping on codeine. I feel like I'm
nice. Man, oh man. This is definitely a nice colorway. To be honest with you guys, this is the first mid-top Jordan 1 that I actually have in my collection. And I was honestly surprised when I went into Foot Locker and this was on the shelf. I was hoping that the lady said when I went in there, oh, they didn't have my size. But she actually brought out my size 10, so I definitely had to pick this up. If you're not familiar with this sneaker, this is the new version 2017 Air Jordan 1 mids new love. I know the last time this pair actually came out, I think it was 2010 if I'm not mistaken, or 2007. It could be one of them. I'm not really 100% sure, but it was the new love Olove pack. It came with this actual sneaker and the Chicago ones as well. It was great packaging. Unfortunately, I don't have that pair, but this is one of the two, and I was able to get this to add to the collection. So let's check the details out. As you can see, it does come with two laces already pre-laced in a solid black, and you have the yellow laces in the bag. As you can see, you have the standard Air Jordan Wings logo here along the high ankle area. The material here, I thought it was like nubuck, but it kind of feels rubbery. It kind of feels like plastic here. I'm not really too sure exactly what the materials here is, as well as the patch here behind the actual swoosh. It's the same material. You do have a nice synthetic leather here on the yellow. You do have a white midsole with that gum translucent outsole. As we move to the toe box, you have your standard synthetic leather here on the actual toe box, which isn't that bad. I've seen worse and I've seen better. This is pretty standard. You do have black flat laces that's already pre-laced with the Air Jordan Jumpman logo on the actual tongue. As we go to the medial side, you can see it's pretty much the same layout with your yellow hits here on the actual ankle area, as well as the swoosh. And you have the plastic, AKA nubuck or whatever this material is here. As we go to the back of the heel, you have a solid black stitch Jumpman logo here on the back. As we go to the insole of it, it is a solid black insole with a yellow Jumpman Jordan logo. And the actual interior of the sneaker kind of feels like a, I guess you would call it like a nylon material on the inside. Pretty different. It's not cotton. And it's the same thing on the back of the tongue as well. As you can see, I want that to focus. There you go. As we go to the outsole, you can see the outsole is pretty standard with all Jordan 1s. Like I said, the outsole is kind of like a gum color, but it is translucent. You do have the Nike brand in there, dead center, along with your pop-up stars on the forefront of the sneaker. To be honest with you guys, this is definitely a nice sneaker. If you know me, you know I'm a very big Jordan 1 fan. So the minute I saw these on the shelf, like I said, this was something that I needed to have in my collection. And also due to the fact that I don't have a yellow and black Jordan 1, new love, old love pack, or the new love 2007 version. So it was definitely a great pickup to add to the collection. Definitely want to thank everyone once again for tuning in to another episode of BKO Reviews. Definitely want to tell everyone once again, if you enjoyed the content, show your love and support by hitting that thumbs up button. It goes a long way. Also, if you're new to the channel, and I pray that you isn't, please subscribe. It's your best way of staying up to date with the most recent content. And you can also follow me on these social media platforms. We post videos every Sunday at 12 noon. And once again, I definitely want to thank everyone for tuning in to another episode of BKO Reviews.